الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله يا ايها الذين امنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن الا وانتم مسلمون يا ايها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحده وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. So inshallah today we just have one session which is the Nahw, and next week we can go with the norm inshallah. Okay. What was the last topic in Nahw? Al-fi'lu, bab al-fi'l, right? We mentioned that al-fi'l.
Come on, you have tissue.
Tissue. Okay, so يقول المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى والفعل يعرف بقد والسين وسوف وتاء التأنيث الساكنة والفعل يعرف بقد والسين وسوف وتاء التأنيث الساكنة. So he mentioned four علامة للفعل. Right. The first علامة is دخول قد عليه والسين وسوف وتاء التأنيث الساكنة. What does that mean? It means whenever we see a word that is preceded by قد, what does that mean? That word is a فعل. Likewise, seed. And likewise, the تاء التأنيث, when a word ended with تاء التأنيث الساكنة. Likewise, سوف. So we have قد, we have seen, we have سوف, we have تاء التأنيث الساكنة. Last week we mentioned that قد تدخل على إيش؟ تدخل على الماضي والمضارع. تدخل على الماضي والمضارع. قد يعلم الله المعوقين منكم. قد علم ولا قد علمتم الذين اعتدوا منكم في السبت فقلنا لهم كونوا قردة خاسئين. قد أفلح المؤمنون. The seen cannot be with مضارع, right? Because it is for what? التنفيس, right? And the seen and سوف, they always go with what? مضارع أو ماضي. مضارع cannot be with الماضي. They cannot go with the ماضي because they mean respite. Somebody's something that should take place in the future, near future, or father, future, whatsoever. I mean, it means something is going to take place or the action is going to happen, not now. It will happen afterwards. Afterwards means starting from the moment the speaker closes his mouth or keeps quiet after he released the command or he talks. That's the seed. So, that's why it doesn't go with what? It doesn't go with the ماضي. It goes with the مضارع. It goes with the مضارع. I cannot say ستعلمت. ستعلم. So it goes with the مضارع and it goes with the مضارع. كلا سوف تعلمون. So seen and سوف, both of them go with, they cannot go with ماضي because ماضي already happen, and they can only go with the مضارع. سوف تعلمون, because مضارع is for مستقبل, or for the current situation. So سوف تعلم, you will know. The تاو التأنيث, like what? قالت المرأة, قالت المرأة. So this ta, this is what we call ta utanif, and it shows that what is connected with it is fi'l. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قالت عجوز عقيم. The wife of Ibrahim alayhi salam, she said, قالت عجوز عقيم. So دخول ta التأنيث على الكلمة يدل على أن تلك الكلمة فعل. So whenever we see ta utanif being connected in the, to a word, I mean the last part of the word, we will learn from here that this kalima is what? Is fa'al. So we have four alamat, this is just a revision. يقول المؤلف وتاء التأنيث الساكنة احترازا من غير الساكنة فإن تاء التأنيث غير الساكنة ليس من علامات الفعل. So the reason why he says تاء التأنيث الساكنة سورة, we will know that this is only talking about ta'u ta'anif as-sakina. The ta which is for ta'anif that is not sakina and al-mutaharrika, I mean doesn't necessarily make the word fair. Shajaratu, you get it? This is ta'u ta'anif also. Tamaratu, this is ta'u ta'anif also. Baqaratu, this is ta'u ta'anif also. But it doesn't mean that the word they are connected to is fair. Because shajaratun, shajarun, شجرٌ شجرةٌ شجرٌ is not fa'al, it's ism, right? بقرةٌ the same thing. No. قال الله تعالى هذه, قال هذا رحمة من ربي. رحمة من ربي, رحمة is a name, it's ism, it's not fa'al. Okay, the new lesson. He says علامات الحرف. قال والحرف لا ما لا يصلح معه دليل الاسم ولا دليل الفعل. والحرف ما لا يصلح معه دليل الاسم ولا دليل الفعل. والحرف ما لا يصلح معه دليل الفعل ولا دليل الاسم ولا دليل الفعل. والحرف ما لا يصلح معه دليل الاسم ولا دليل الفعل. حرف. So we know the alamat for the ism. What are the alamat for the ism? Al-alif wal-lam. What else? Al-tanween. Huruf al-jar. Al-khaf. Jawazu kawnihi fa'ilan. Jawazu kawnihi maf'ulan. Jawazu al-ikhbari anhu. These are all alamat li al-ism. When it comes to the fi'l, we have also four alamat mentioned for this. Dukhul qad alayhi. والسين وسوف وتاء التأنيث الساكنة. And now in the last word, which is the قسم من أقسام الكلمة, الكلام. You see, أقسام الكلام ثلاثة: الفعل, الاسم والفعل والحرف. الاسم والفعل والحرف. So we talk about اسم, we talk about فعل. Now we're talking about the last one, which is the حرف. I know how to recognize اسم, and I know how to recognize فعل. And now we're going to be trying to know how to recognize a harf. When I see a word, how do I know that this is harf, this is fa'al, this is... So I know how to get the fa'al, and I know how to get the ism, but now how to get the harf. قال والحرف ما لا يصلح معه دليل الكلمة ولا دليل الاسم ولا دليل الفعل. He said الحرف is anything that doesn't fit, I mean, Dalil is a guidance. I mean, alama, something that lets you know that this word is this and that. You see, I have a word, baytun. How do I know bayt? Let's say I just say bayt. I don't write the harakat or sakanat. I just keep it like that, bayt. How do I know that this bayt is a name or fi'l or verb a harf, letter? I try everything. Can I say qad baytun? No, it doesn't go. Sabaytun doesn't go. Baytut, okay, it doesn't go. So, what else we have for sawfa baytun? It doesn't work. But baytun, yeah, it works. So tanween get inside. Because of the tanween,
because of the tanween being possible to be attached to that word, we learn that this word is, you get it, that's what is called dalil. Tanween is dalil. There are adilla, there are dalil, evidence, signs that can guide you to recognize a name. There are signs that can help you to recognize a verb. None of the signs which guides you to a name or a fi'l can work with harf. So any work that whatever you connect it with of those guidance that can guide you to ism or fi'l, it doesn't work with that word, then we know that this word is what?
Harf.
We try to attach those signs for the name, it doesn't work. We try to attach those signs for the fi'l, it doesn't work. So we learn from this that harf is what? And that word is what? Harf. That's why Al-Hariri has a very nice bait that you don't like to hear. But he says, وَالْحَرْفُ مَا لَيْسَتْ لَهُ عَلَامًا. Right? Harf is the one that has no alama. I mean, we have alama for ism, alama for harf, but harf, alama for fi'l, but harf doesn't have alama at all. So any word that has no alama that can help you to recognize its nature, this harf, this word is called harf. Clear? That's why he says, مَا لَا يَصْلُحُ مَعْهُ. What the little harf and the little ism doesn't fit it. I mean, they don't fit it, both of them, they don't fit a kalima, then we know that this kalima is what? It's harf. كُلُّ كَلِمَةٍ تَعْرِضُ عَلَيْهَا دَلِيلُ الْإِسْمِ وَلَا تَكْبَلُ. Sheikh said, from this text of Al-Ajrumi, he said, we learn that every kalima that you try to connect it with those alamat for the ism, وَلَا تَكْبَلُوا, it doesn't accept. I try to let them become friend of alamat al-ism, it doesn't accept. وَتَعْرِضُ عَلَيْهَا دَلِيلُ الْفِعْلِ وَلَا تَكْبَلُوا. And you try to connect it with the dalil al-fi'l, and it doesn't accept it. فَهِيَ حَرْفٌ. This word is harf. فَالْحَرْفُ مَا لَا يَسْلُحُ مَعْهُ دَلِيلُ الْإِسْمُ وَلَا دَلِيلُ الْفِعْلِ. يقول الحريري في الملحة, والحرف ما ليست له علامة فقس على قولي تكن علامة. Whatsoever has no دليل, no علامة, then we call it what? We call it harf. فإذا وجدت كلمة عرضت عليها علامات الاسم فما قبلت, وعرضت عليها علامات الفعل فما قبلت فهي حرف. That's what I said. فإن قال قائل كيف تجعلون علامة الحرف عدمية والعلامة عالم ولا بد أن يكون أمرا موجودا وجوديا. So this is just a contradiction brought by Sheikh. He said, if somebody is to talk to you and to criticize this definition of harf, what is harf? Anything that has no alama. And somebody asks you, what is the alama for the harf? You said the alama for the harf is no alama. Somebody might tell you, come on, that doesn't make sense. When something becomes alama, that means it can be seen. Okay, you're going to go to where? Let's say to the library. You have never been to UI. This is the first time you arrive in UI. And I don't have time to take you to the place. How should I guide you to the place? I tell you, if you go down there, you will see a sign that says, go here, you go to this place, go to that place. After that, you take another sign that takes you to this place. These are alamat. How do you, at the end of the day, you end up going to the library. Through what? The alama. These alamat, they were able to guide you because you can see them, right? If you don't see them, how did it become alama then? Do you get the point that they are raising here? I mean, alama is something to be seen. If I don't see it, how does it become alama also? I need somebody to guide me to it, actually, if I cannot see it, right? So here they said, alama tul harfi, annahu laysat lahu alama. And the sign for the harf is, it doesn't have any sign. قال الجواب, إنه إذا كان شيء محصورا صح أن تكون العلامة عدمية. فهنا علامة الاسم كذا وعلامة الفعل كذا والذي لا يدخل في علامات هذا ولا هذا صار معلوما. Okay. He said, whenever you have a concept, and this concept is known, I was restricted and confined in a place. You have three things to define kalam, right? Ism, fi'l. I mean, three pillars of four kalam. To construct kalam, you have three things: ismun, fi'lun, and harf. Do you get it? These are the three things that exist in Arabic language. True? We don't have anything else. Either ism, or fi'l, or harf. If I come, I tell you, okay, the alama for ism is this. The alama for harf is this. The alama for fi'l is this. Do I need to tell you the alama for harf? Do I need to tell you the alama for harf? No, because there are only three. If I tell you, okay, this one takes this and the other one takes that, that means whatsoever is not this and is not that is what? It's harf. Do you get the point? So in this case, we cannot say the alamatu fi'l adamiyya. Adamiyya means something that does not exist. No, it does exist. How do we recognize it? By looking at fi'l and ism. Know what is fi'l and know what is harf. Anything other than fi'l and, know what is ism and know what is al-fi'l. Whatsoever is not fi'l and it is not ism is what? Is harf. That's obvious, sir. Do you get it? If we have something else which is not harf, not ism, not fi'l, yes, we need something to differentiate between that thing and the harf, but we don't have. What does that mean? In Arabic language, they have only three things, either ism or fi'l or harf. If I know what constitute harf and what constitute ism and what constitute fi'l, that means whatsoever is not fi'l and whatsoever is not ism is what? Is harf then. Okay, سؤال. The letter تكلم, is it حرف? تكلم, not حرف. Is it حرف? تكلم, it's فعل. Abdurrahman, let them change their mind quickly. Can you just write it down? Maybe because they don't see it. That's why they made a mistake. Actually, I'm not saying it's a mistake, but let's see. Okay, now. تكلم. This is تكلم. الشد على اللام. تكلم. Okay. تكلم. Is it حرف or فعل? Harf, fi'l, right. Okay. Is there anyone who has any comment or rejection I don't want to accept? Because we already studied, you agree with the wrong answer, right? Okay, good. Rahman, remove the, which Abdurrahman? It's not you, of course. Remove the first letter. Does it make sense? Kallama. Does it make sense? Yes, right. So the ta, is it part of the word or it is an external visitor, right? That's why you remember last time, but I know you already forgot or you did not even memorize. We say there are huruf to govern al-fi'l al-mudari', right? They call them huruf al-mudara'. They call them what? Harf. So some part of it is fi'l. Because min bunyat al-kalima, I mean they are part of the word, like kaf, la, mim. These are part of the word. They will never disappear. But sometimes we add something. Takallama, the ta is not part of the word. It's a visitor to let you know that this fi'l is mudara or something else. The word hal. Is it fi'l? Is it harf? Yes, sure. Why harf? I would like to know this. Why harf? Yes. Yes. We cannot say kadhal. We cannot say kadhal. So he can say, but it has no meaning, right? We cannot say what? Halun. Okay. We'll try to find a word in Arabic called halun. So we cannot put tanween in it. How about alif wal lam? Does it go with it? How about fi? Put fi hal. It doesn't go. And in the shi'r sometimes they said wafi hal ataka, and it goes also wafi hal ataka in the poetry, and it goes and it gives a very excellent meaning. Also I can make it like that, but when does fi, but now the fi is connected to the hal, because in the normal what do you call statement, we don't make it like that. We don't say fi hal ataka. We don't say fi qaf. But it is okay because that hal ataka is a name of a surah. That word is like a name, the whole thing. That's why it goes inside. Do you get it? The fi now is not connected to what do you call the hal itself. I'm talking about the surah. Fi qul ya ayyuhal kafirun. That's fi qul. It's okay. And that's why you say what do you call fil mu'minun. They don't say fil mu'minin. They say fil mu'minun if they're talking about surah al mu'minun. They don't say fil mu'minin. They said fil mu'minun because that was the name. They keep the what do you call the waw al jama'ah. It was supposed to be fil mu'minina. But they say fil mu'minun so that you will understand that they were referring to the surah, the name of the surah. Okay. So anyway, thank you very much. They say the harf is what? Whatsoever has no alama to make it recognize or differentiate it between what do you call the ism and the fi'l. It means if you take off the alamat of harf, fi'l, and the alamat of al-ism, whatsoever left, we give it to who? We give it to who? To harf. So we know what constitutes a name, and we know what constitutes a fi'l. So whatever remains, we give it to the harf. وَالْحَرْفُ مَا لَيْسَتْ لَهُ عَلَامَةٌ فَقِسْ عَلَىٰ قَوْلِي تَكُنْ عَلَّامَةٌ. Okay, so that's the last thing we should talk about, this Aqsamul Kalam. The next one is, since we still have time, is about I'rab. But before we go to I'rab, any question about what passed? We learned that Aqsamul Kalam kam? Arba wa khamsa? Thalatha. What are they? Al-ismu, wal-fi'l, wal-harf, right. And we have, when you look at this, kalam, we have kalam, we have kalima, we have qawl, we have kalim, right. What is kalam? What is kalam? Al-lafzu, al-murakkab, al-mufid. بالوضعي اللفظ المركب المفيد بالوضعي. That's kalam, right. What is kalim? اللفظ المركب اللفظ ما يتلفظ به, right. النطق باللسان, right. We have to say it with the tongue. المركب it must be more than one, right? Al-Mufid, it has to make sense, right? Something that makes sense. What is that thing that makes sense? Something that yahsun sukutu alayhi, that you can stop at that moment and the listener will never wait for you to complete your statement. That's al-ifada. The last one is al-wadu. Al-wadu yani al-wadu al-arabi. It has to be part of the Arabic language because we're talking about Arabic language. And also it has to be something that the one who says it, he intended the word. So that we will take out the kalam al-sakran, somebody who is intoxicated, and the majnoon, somebody who is insane, wal na'im, somebody who talks in sleep, in a state of sleep. Al-lafdhu al-murakkab mufid bil-wad'i. Al-kalim. What is the difference between al-kalim wal-kalam? Al-kalim? Do you know kalim? Okay. If I say to you, إذا دخلت البيت, and then I keep quiet. إذا دخلت المسجد, and then I keep quiet. Let me take hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. إذا جاء أحدكم المسجد, and then I keep quiet. What is that? كلام or كلم? كلم. Why كلم? Because it's more than two words, right? Three and above. إذا دخل أحدكم المسجد. You get it? Five words. But does it make sense? It doesn't make sense, right? That means you will be waiting for me to complete my statement. So this is not kalam, but it is kalim. You get it? But when I say, إذا دخل أحدكم المسجد فلا يجلس, is it kalam? Yes, kalam. Although there is something to come after this, right? But it makes sense even if I stop here. إذا دخل أحدكم المسجد فلا يجلس. Whoever gets into the masjid, he should not sit. Do you get it? So to complete the hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, فَلَا يَجْلِسْ حَتَّى يُصَلِّي رَكَعَتَيْنِ. حَتَّى يُصَلِّي رَكَعَتَيْنِ. Shouldn't sit down before he prays two rak'at. Is that clear? What is that? Is it kalam? Yes. Is it kalim? Yes. It's kalim and kalam. The difference between kalam and kalim, it is not necessarily to make sense, but it has to be more than two words. But kalam, it necessary to make sense, and it can be constructed with two words and above. You get it? Kalim has to be more than two. Kalam, two and above. You get it? And kalim it is not necessary for it to make sense, but for kalam, it necessary for kalam to make sense. How about qawl? Kalima is one, right? Kalimatun is one word. How about qawl? Anything, right? Whatever is said. If I say, إِذَا دَخَلَ أَحَدُكُمُ الْمَسْجِدَ is, I keep quiet, is kalim and qawl also. You get it? If I say, إِذَا دَخَلَ أَحَدُكُمُ الْمَسْجِدَ فَلَا يَجْلِسْ is kalim and kalam and qawl also. فَلَا يَجْلِسْ حَتَّى يُسَلِّي رَكَعَتَيْنِ is kalim and kalam and qawl. Okay. So we have أقسام الكلام ثلاثة, right? الاسم, الفعل, والحرف. والاسم له كم علامة? We mentioned how many علامات for اسم? الألف واللام, التنوين, الخفض, حروف الخفض, and what else? And جواز كونه فاعلا, جواز كونه مفعولا, جواز الإخبار عنه, right? And جواز الإخبار عنه, and حروف القسم. This one, they're like حروف الجر, حروف القسم. What are they? الواو والتاء والباء. And الفعل, ما هي علامات الفعل? أربعة كذلك ذكرناها. قد, وهي تدخل على إيش? الماضي والمضارع والسين وهي تدخل على إيش المضارع فقط cannot go with ماضي right yes وسوف تدخل على المضارع ولا تدخل على الماضي وتاء التأنيث تاء التأنيث الساكنة والمتحركة الساكنة we mention ساكنة سورة متحركة will go out of the definition how do we define حرف what is علامة for حرف أنه ليست له علامة يقول الحريري والحرف ما ليست له علامة فقس على قولي تكن علامة any question okay if you don't have question let me just take a little at least the definition of إعراب and then inshallah next class when we come we will go into the details this إعراب is going to take us a long a period of time before we finish it so let us just define it today and then we come back afterward inshallah ta'ala next week we to discuss the details قال باب الإعراب والإعراب هو تغيير أواخر الكلمة لاختلاف العوامل الداخلة عليها لفظا أو تقديرا الإعراب تغيير أواخر الكلمة لاختلاف العوامل الداخلة عليها لفظا أو تقديرا الإعراب تغيير أواخر الكلمة لاختلاف العوامل الداخلة عليها لفظا أو إعرابا أو تقديرا الإعراب تغيير أواخر الكلمة لاختلاف العوامل الداخلة عليها لفظا أو تقديرا الإعراب تغيير أواخر الكلمة لاختلاف العوامل الداخلة عليها لفظا أو تقديرا okay. الإعراب what is the meaning of إعراب من أعرب أعرب عن الشيء بمعنى أفصح عنه وتقول أعربت عما في نفسي أفصحت فالإعراب في اللغة هو الإفصاح عن الشيء لكنه في الاصطلاح كذا وكذا ما هو الإعراب في اللغة linguistically when we say إعراب we're talking about what الإفصاح to make something clear to bring out and when I say أعربت عما في نفسي أفصحت يعني I brought out what is in my mind I make it clear to the audience do you get it making something clear that's the language right bayan to explain something to make something more clear that's in the language right so when I say to you al-i'rab and I'm talking about the language that was what should be understood but in the istilah istilah means istilah al-nahwiyin the terms I mean, according to the Nahwiyin, the scholars of the Nahw, the scholars of the field, I mean, who are concerned with the Nahw discipline, when they say I'rab, what does that mean? They're talking about تغيير أواخر الكلمة لاختلاف العوامل الداخلة عليها لفظا أو تقديرا. The change that usually take place at the last part of the word due to the, connection or the link that the word have because it is preceded by certain words, variables or awamil means things that whenever they connected to a word, they will change it to another nature. Okay, Brahma, please just write for me, yaf'alu. In front, write for me al-insanu. Write at last ma'rufan. See, yaf'alu. The last part, the focus, I want you to focus because the focus of Nahu is the last part of the word. Unlike the Sarf, it goes to the first, last and middle. Good. But Nahu is focusing on the last part of the word. So when you have the يفعلوا, originally according to the language, Dhamma should take the root. The words usually are like that. They end with Dhamma. Unless if they are مبنيات. You get it? So يفعلوا, Al-insanu. Do you get it? Yaf'alu al-insanu ma'rufan. Al-insan became insanu, not insana, not insani, because of amil. Amil means a worker, something that has the power to change it. Ma'rufan, it also became like that, ma'rufan, not ma'rufun, not ma'rufin, because of amil. Is that clear? Amil means something that goes inside and make that change. Do you get it? Yaf'alu al-insanu ma'rufan. Yaf'alu remains in the way it is because there is nothing before it to change its nature. I just want you to understand, what do they mean by amil? Amil usually literally means a worker, right? What do they mean by amil? Put an at the beginning. Someone just remain standing, otherwise we'll keep on telling you, go on that, go and come back. Okay, when I put an, the word fi'l, yaf'alu, will never remain like that. Change it to fatha. What makes it maftuh, mansuba, an? If I put hatta also, it's going to be like that. Hatta yaf'ala. If I put in, this in, just change the thing to become in. In, that one is going to be sukun. Now, in yaf'al al-insan, it changes to sukun because of the in. You get al-shartiyya. In yaf'al. But if you read it, you want to say in yaf'al al-insan, because the iltika was sakin, in two sukun they met, you have to cancel one of them. But in reality, it's in yaf'al. You get it? فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ. It doesn't say فَمَنْ يَعْمَلُ. It says فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَى. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَى. So you see, there's something to come and be connected to the fi'l, and it changed the fi'l from jazma to fatha to dhamma sometimes. Do you get it? This thing that causes this change, they call it amil. Because it like the worker, right? The worker works in something and changes from a nature to another nature. So they say, al-insan. If I want to change it, I can say, insan here, is it insan? Al-insan, because it is what? Fa'il. Because it is the one who does the act. Having this nature of being the one who does an act causes it to be marfu'. That's why I said insan. You get it? If I want to change it, I can say innal insana. You get it? Min al insani. So min and ande wa awamil. The one that changes this. So when they say al i'rabu taghyiru, the change, taghyir means the change that takes place. Taghyiru awakhir al kalimi. Awakhir means the last part of the word. لاختلاف الأوامر الداخل عليها, because of the change that we have in the awamil that are connected to that kalima. I guess this one is clear, inshallah. It is connected with min, it takes another nature. It is connected with kaf, with kana, it takes another nature. It is connected with anna, it gets another. Inna al-insana, kana al-insanu, min al-insani. You see, when kana comes, it makes it marfu', madmum. When inna comes, it makes it mansub, fatha. When min comes, it makes it majru, jarra. So those kana and min and inna, they're all awamil. Clear? So taghyiru awakhir al-kalimi, the change that takes place at the last part of the word, لِاخْتِلَافِ الْعَوَامِلِ الدَّاخِلَةِ عَلَيْهَا, due to the differences that we have in the awamil that goes and connect with that word, lafzan aw taqdira, whether it is love or based on assumption. We will learn about this, inshallah. What do we mean by love? And what do we mean by assumptions? I mean, we just assume that something is there, that's why it is like that. And in that one, love them means we say it, you pronounce it, the word, the amid, you pronounce it. But then, you pronounce it, also you can see it also. See and pronounce and also see it in the writing. I mean, you can write it down and you can pronounce it. But there are some, you can just pronounce it, but you don't write it down. Inshallah, we will talk about about this. So I will repeat the definition. It says al-i'rab lughatan al-ifsah an shay. Wa istilahan taghyir awakhir al-kalimi li ikhtilaf al-awamil al-dakhilati 'alayha. The change that takes place at the last part of the word due to what? Due to the differences and the change you have in the awamil that are connected, and the word, and that word is preceded with it. Allahu a'lam. So I don't want to go into the much detail, but the explanation inshallah will come in the next class, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala. So al-i'rabu lughatan huwa al-ifsah 'an al-shay'i wa istilahan taghyir awakhir al-kalimi li-ikhtilaf al-awamil al-dakhilati 'alayha lafzan aw taqdira. Allahu a'lam. If you have question, then I address the question. So please do keep on being patient and come right. Class goes fluctuate. The best example of fluctuation is our class. Sometimes come a lot, sometimes. Okay, I don't want to mention the other one, but we will not stop, inshallah. As long as there is one, two people coming, we will continue, reason light on, inshallah. So exercise patience and keep coming. And convince the rest. Tell them to show some mercy to the class and come, inshallah. Inshallah. Any question? Any question? What about? No problem. I mean, you pray with the imam and the imam missed the first tashahud, right? So he goes, so you thought this is the third rak'ah. So then after a few minutes, you hear the imam going for ruku. In this case, no problem. You just stand up immediately. Stand up immediately and go for ruku with the imam. That's it. No, you don't repeat the rak'ah. Stand up and make the standing. You get it? Stand up and make the standing and then follow the imam. You don't need to repeat the rak'ah because you're with him. And that was his fault, and you are following. You thought that was what happened. So all that you have to do is at the end you make, sujood. He's going to make sujood. You just follow him in that sujood, the prayer is fixed, inshallah. Just follow him in that sujood and the prayer is fixed, inshallah. That's why it is always good, they say, to open at least something that the sisters can see. In the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they don't have any barrier. They have this open area. Sisters are behind and the brothers in front, so they see what is going on in the masjid. So in our time, some people say, people change. Yes, do. Definitely people change, but it doesn't mean we should change completely in the way we create chaos in the society. At least open some lines where they see what is going on. If you don't open all this, open some lines where they can see. Otherwise, it will keep on happening like that. The imam makes sujood tilawa. What do you think he's doing? Ruku. You go for ruku, and the imam is in the sujood tilawa. And then at the end of the day, questions will come. What to do? But if they see him or one see, at least. One of them, the one who sees, is going to go for sujood, and the remainder of the people will follow. Us also in the male place also is like that, because the imam might be reading a place where there is no sujood, there is a sujood tilawa, He does the sujood salah, but not everyone knows it. But then people will get stuck. I'm telling you, every time it's like that. Some of us will go for ruku, some of us will go for sujood, some of us will be stuck waiting like that to see what to do. Because they will be thinking that maybe imam is wrong. You get it? So they don't know whom to follow. Is it the ma'mum who make the sujood with the imam, or the one who goes for ruku? They will get stuck. Not in ruku, not in sujood. Waiting to see what will happen. So it's always like that. That's why some scholars said, even you try, don't read those places of sujood if you know that it will make people confused. Do you get it? But it's okay to be right, but this is knowledge. But this is what should be done. The place of the sisters, at least they should have some space where they can see what is going on in the main masjid. Yes. Yeah. You cannot pray in the way the place where the sisters are. So you pray in the ground floor behind the brothers. You can see them, what they do. You can see the brothers, right? The imam or the ma'mum, right? Underground. Okay. It's better not to do. Because there are some scholars who believe, and that opinion is so strong, as long as the place is not connected to the masjid and you don't see the imam, you don't follow. And also anything can happen. If the mic gets some problem, then you get stuck and you don't know what to do. So in that case, since you're not even required actually to pray in the masjid, why don't you just leave the prayer until you go back to your room? Or come when they finish and then pray in the place where you can pray, which will not affect your health. I mean, we don't say you have to come to the masjid and join the jama'ah. Well, your health will be affected. Nobody says that. I mean, even the man who is supposed to go to the masjid and pray, if he's sick, he doesn't need to go to the masjid. He can pray at home. So what do you think will be the situation of a sister who is not required actually to go? She just go based on her own willing. Do you get what I mean? So the best is, instead of you praying in that situation where some scholars have some concern of your prayer, why don't you just wait until you go back home, as long as the time for the prayer will not finish, or after they finish the prayer, so that we will not have two different prayers. The people are praying here and you are praying differently. You get it? And people, they will have bad thoughts about you. Maybe you don't want to pray with the imam or something like this. So you wait for them until they finish the prayer. Then you come to the masjid and pray separately, inshallah. But I will never suggest you to pray in a place where you can hear the voice but you don't see the imam. There are a great concern about this issue by the scholars. Some of them believe that your prayer is gone, is void. Allah accept. Okay. Next. Any more? Okay, thank you very much. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.